Hello dear children, this is class 8 maths class. In the previous class we have started chapter in 3 squares and square roots. We have started exercise we have done in the previous class till question number 3. Now we are going to start question number 4. Question number 4 is find the square root of each of the following. The first part of this question is 1.5129. We have to find out the square root of 1.5129. For that, let us first we will write down 1.5129 and we will find out the square root of this number by long divisional method. If it is not given by which method you have to find out the square root, then dear students, try to find out the square root by long divisional method because it will be very easy for you. So let us start. First we will make it a pair from the right hand side like this. One will remain alone. So let us divide this one first. 1 1 ja 1, and here we will subtract and here we are going to add them. So 1 plus 1 it will be 2 and 1 1 cancel out. Now 51 we will take it down. Now by which number we will multiply? We will multiply here so that it will become 51 or less than 51, so by 2. So here we will take it to the new number 2 and the same number we have to multiply it. So 22 2 ja 44, we will not take here 3 because if we will take it 3 here then it will be 23 3 ja 69, it will be bigger than 51, so it is better to take 2. So 22 2 ja 44. Now subtract, if we will get it here 7, and this 29 will take it down. Now it will become 729, and here let us add this number 2 plus 2 4 and 2, and now by which number we will multiply this here so that it will become 729. So it will be 3 3 3 ja 9 3 4 ja 12, carry 1 3 2 ja 6 plus 1 7 729. By subtracting we'll get it 00 here. So what will be the answer? The square root of 1.5129 is equal to 1.29. this will be our answer. Now let us see the next question. Second part is 20.7936. we will write down first 20.7936 and then we will make it a pair. For that we will write down here, we will make it bar over here. So 20 is coming in a pair, so by which number we will multiply so that we will get it 20? There is no any number because 5 5 is 25, so we have to take it 4 4 4 is 16. After subtracting it we will get it here 4. Now before taking the 79 down, we have to transpose this decimal this side. Now we will transpose, after then we will take it 79 down. Now 4 plus 4 8, and here we have to multiply it by 5. So 85 5 is 425. Now by subtracting we will get it here 54, and then 36 will come down. Now by adding 5 plus 5 10 8 plus 1 9 90, then we will multiply this number by 6 both side, so it will become 5 4 3 6. Therefore the square root of 20.7936 is equal to 4.56. this will be our answer. Now we will see the next question, number 5. Find the square root. It is given in the mixed fraction 1252 by 81. So first of all we have to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. After converting it we will get it here 1024 upon 81. Now we have to find out the square root of 1024 upon 81. So we will find out the square root of both numerator and denominator separately. So let us find out first the square root of 1024. We will make it pair here. It will be 10, so 3 3 is 9. By subtracting we will get it here 1, and 3 plus 3, it will be 6, and this 24 will come down. So by which number we will multiply? 2. So 32, it will be 00. So the square root of 1024 is equal to 32, and the square root of 81 is equal to 9. Therefore the square root of 1024 upon 81 is equal to 32 by 9. This is our answer. Now the next question is find the square root of each of the following correct to two decimal places. It is mentioned here in the question that we have to find out the square root of the given number correct to two decimal places, up to two decimal places. So what will be the square root of two? So let us find out. We will write down 2 here and then we will divide this number. 1 1 1, we can't take 2 here because 2 2 4, it will exceed this 2, so it will go by 1 times. 1 1 1, so here we will write down 1, and after subtracting we will get it here 1. 1 plus 1, it will be 2. Now listen here, try to understand. There is no any number, so what we have to do, we will put it here a decimal, as in the division also we are, if there is no number, so what we are doing, we are putting one decimal and taking one zero downside. So here also, here we will put it one decimal, and instead of 10 we will take it 20 this side, so it will become 100. Now by which number we have to multiply? By 4. 24 4 96, after subtracting, so here we will write down 4, after subtracting we'll get it 4, and since we have taken one decimal, so we are free to take 20 in every step. So here we will get it 20 again. So now 4 plus 4 8, and 2. Now by which number we have to multiply here so that we can get it? 400 by 1. So 281 vanja, 281. After subtracting we'll get it here 119. So here we will write down 1. So up to 2 decimal places, we can say that root 2 is equal to 1.41 will be our answer. This will be our answer. Let us see the next question. Find the value of root 5 correct to 2 decimal places, then find the value of the square root of 3 minus root 5 upon 3 plus root 5 correct to 2 decimal places. Let us see. First of all, we will find out the square root of 5 here. How will you find? First we'll write down 5, and then let us see by which number we have to multiply so that we'll get it 5. There is no any number. We can't take 3, 3, 3 is a 9, it will be 3, 3 is a 9. It will exceed this 5, so we'll take it 2. 2, 2 is a 4, here we will write down 2 and here 4. By subtracting we'll get it 1 here, and 2 plus 2, 4. Now we'll take it decimal here because there is no any digit, so we'll take it a decimal here, and instead of this digit, since we have taken here a decimal, so we'll get it here 20. Now this, it become 100. Now by which number we have to multiply? By 2. 42 2 is 84. By subtracting we'll get it 16. Now 2 plus 2 4 and 4, and now again we will take it 20 in every step. We are 20 will come, we'll get it 20 as a free in every step. So here it will become 1600. By which number we have to multiply? 3. So it will become 1329. And after subtracting we'll get it 271. By adding this number, 3 plus 3 6 4 4 4 46. Now by which number we have to multiply so that we can get it 27100? It will divided by, multiplied by 6. When you will multiply this number 4466 by 6, you will get it 26796. So this will be the answer of root 5. Root 5 is equal to 2.236. by rounding off we can write down 2.24. here we have rounded this number, round figure we have taken, so it will become 2.25. now let us see. 3 minus root 5 upon 3 plus root 5, root over. So to rationalize this number, what there is one rule, what we have to do here, it is written plus, so both side we have to multiply it by negative sign. 3 minus root 5 upon 3 plus root 5 into, here it is, if it is written plus, then we have to multiply both side by negative sign. If there is negative sign, then we have to multiply it by positive sign. So let us multiply. 3 minus root 5 upon 3 minus root 5, that is equal to 3 minus root 5. 3 minus root 5 means 3 minus root 5 whole square. It is 2 times, so we will write down here 2. Upon a plus b into a minus b, there is one formula, no? A plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square, means 3 into 3, that is equal to 9, and root 5 into root 5, that is equal to 5. So now here a minus b whole square means a square minus 2ab plus b square means 3 square 9, 2ab, 3 into 2 into 3 into root 5, that is equal to 6 root 5 plus b square. B square means 5 square, means root 5 square means 5 upon 9 minus 5, 4. Now 9 plus 5, 14 minus 6 root 5 upon 4, that is equal to 14 minus, let us put it their value of root 5, minus 14 minus 6 into 2.24 upon 4. Now 14 minus, when you will multiply this 6 into 2.24, it will become 13.44. So 14 minus 13.44, that is equal to 0.56 upon 4 root over. Now when you will divide, you will get it to 0.14, and the square root of 0.14 is equal to 0.3741, or by rounding off this number, you will get it 0.38 will be your answer. This will be your answer. So 0.38 will be your answer. So children, today this much only. We will see in the next class. Next part we'll see in the next class. Thank you.